also needs no introduction, Mr. Farland Chang.
Yes.
He's going to say a few words, 说几句话关于他的朋友, 因为 because Mike, Farland helped us bring Mike to STU. So we have to thank Farland for bringing Mike. Can you say a few words, Farland, please?
Thank you so much, Ching Ching. 大家好. 我很高兴今天晚上跟你一起 我很高兴跟你们大家一起
Oh man, Mike, look at this crowd! This is unbelievable!
Alright, now I was here about a year ago and man, I thought you guys filled this theater but this is double what I had.
Yeah, double what I had too.
Yeah, wow. So Mike, I thank the audience for coming out here to welcome our master photographer from the National Geographic and my dear friend and colleague. You may know me as the journalism professor who is teaching storytelling and the art of on-camera performance, which explains partly why I'm carrying this monopod and why I'm carrying this phone. And we're anyway, I'm so happy that I'm here, and I'm so happy that Vice Dean Ching-Ching Ni, as well as Dean Fan and the Journalism School invited me to come out here. I was so impressed with the students last year, and I was so honored when Dean Fan and Dean Ni invited me to come out and teach, and here I am, and I'm having a blast, having an absolute blast teaching. And so after I joined, I told my dear friend and colleague, Mike Yamashita, you have got to come out to Shantou. This is the place. Some of the best and the brightest in China. We are transforming the way that journalism is being taught. We are a pioneer in so many ways in all these different departments. And so it is a blast for me to be able to persuade my colleague, and it didn't take too much persuading either. So, to help introduce him a little further, he doesn't like to talk about himself too much, but I will try to make that a little easier for him, because I am producing a series of documentaries called The Art of the Photographer, and Mike, of course, is the star, and I'd like to show you a little excerpt of that so that you get a feel for who Mike is, so that he doesn't have to talk so much about himself. All right, here we go. A picture says a thousand words, a story says a thousand pictures. Welcome to The Art of the Photographer, I'm Farland Chang. Thank you for joining me on this program as we embark on a journey with Michael Yamashita, the world-acclaimed National Geographic photojournalist, the cameraman's cameraman. Mike has been shooting for the National Geographic magazine for more than 30 years. He's combined his dual passions for photography and travel. And while his focus has been on Asia, his work has taken him to six continents. In this program, we'll travel with Mike through his mind's eye, and we hope you'll walk away with a fresh, insightful new perspective about the world around you. No matter whether you're a professional or amateur photographer, who you are, where you've traveled, or where you're from.
The journey is the destination. Just when you think you've come to the end of your travels, there's another place, another face to shoot, someplace, somewhere else.
I had the privilege of meeting Mike in Hong Kong after working as an anchor for CNN International and correspondent for NBC News. As a fellow storyteller and one dedicated to bridging East and West, I'm honored to help my colleagues share our stories. When Mike is not traveling, he's with his family in rural New Jersey, where he maintains his studio. And that's where I caught up with him. His story now, and the art of the photographer.
Well, for me, the joy of being a photographer is actually the lifestyle. Now, I love travel, and having no formal training, I guess I'm still an amateur. Though I get paid for this. I never studied photography, so I feel very much like any amateur photographer feels about taking pictures. It was a great hobby, and the joy is in the travel and seeing different things, experiencing people's different lives, and it's the experience itself that's enjoyable, as well as then putting it on film, which obviously I'm very making a picture of it, which obviously I'm pretty good at. But I just want to say that photography is not about equipment. I use the finest cameras, and they are important for capturing the highest quality picture I can. But what photography is really about is the vision. And that means whether it's an instant where I am sizing up a scene and immediately have a picture come into my mind, or something that I've planned weeks, months ahead that I want to photograph. The point is that the picture starts here. I have it in my mind. I am seeing something that in my mind's eye that I want to capture in this way. And that makes it also a lot easier, because rather than randomly coming upon a scene and randomly capturing it and hoping that it's going to be good, if you have it here and you see it and recognize it and then can go click, it becomes a hunt, a quest to find this thing that you, when you see it, therefore you recognize it and click, you've got it. So I try and impart to my students when I teach workshops that that's what they should be doing, is thinking very much about the picture they're going to take and forming an image of that, having it in your mind's eye. So you have to go about it in a fairly organized way. And so that's about vision. And then once you find that subject, or once you're onto that subject, number two, then you're going to work that subject. And you're going to work it from many different angles, and perhaps in 1 or 2 days, or you know, morning and afternoon, or if it's an hour, or if it's 30 minutes, whatever it is, whatever time you're going to devote to it, you're going to explore that subject from different angles, perhaps different light, different lenses. Going to explore every possibility to get that subject in the most unique and interesting way.
I feel privileged being a photographer and being able to see scenes like this and record them, because I feel like I'm seeing history and putting it on film, seeing something that won't be here in another 3 or 4 years.
You can't overemphasize light and the impact that's going to have on the photograph. You are out shooting in the best light. That means you got to get up early. You got to be up for the sunrise, because that's the good light, the color, the directional aspect, the warmth of that. And so you need to take advantage of every good lighting situation. Not that you're going to give up shooting any other time of the day, but for sure you're going to be out there giving yourself the big advantage of great light by choosing those landscapes early in the morning and late afternoon.
My favorite time of the day, sunrise. The colors are warm, the light is soft, and everybody's waking up and doing what they do in the morning. We like to call it magic hour, because good things happen with the light.
Hey, Michael, over here. Okay, we gotta show everybody. We gotta put this on WeChat. Oh, look at that. That's another good-looking crowd. There you go.
Scrubbing claws on your hands. give me a zip. Christina's in the back of my limousine, working all day for the agency. About to go party till the sun comes up, and that same old song is keeping up. City living. Show ain't stretching.